Hey everyone, welcome to my series on low frequency RFID. In this video, we're going to look at how the Flipper Zero encodes and decodes FSK signals. FSK is frequency shift keying, where one frequency represents a zero and a different frequency represents a one. FSK is used by manufacturers like HID, AWID, Pyramid, and others. I was going to show how the Flipper encodes and decodes H10301, but my wife said, please don't make another H10301 video. So in this video, we'll make our own protocol used for encoding a GPS coordinate. Let's get started. In this example, I'll encode the location of Toxic Barbecue, which is in Las Vegas on August 8th. I'll be there and hopefully you'll be able to come too. It's the day before the DEF CON conference, which I'll also be attending. Everybody brings food to this pavilion. I can right click and then we can copy the GPS coordinates. I have a little online GDB program. We click on run, right click on the prompt, choose paste as plain text, and then press enter. This script converts the latitude into 4 bytes and the longitude into another 4 bytes. So we can copy those 8 bytes of data. And my Flipper has the encoder installed, so go to 125 kHz, add manually Jameson FEE7, and then we'll enter the data that the script showed us, and then we'll save that file as barbecue. And once it's saved, we'll open it and go down to info, and you can see the hex data that we entered along with the latitude and longitude. Next, we'll click the back button, and then we'll go to write. Put our T5577 tag, and we successfully wrote our tag. I'll go ahead and back out, and then we'll go into read, and the tag has the coordinates. Next, we'll go ahead and put our tag on the ProxMark, and then we'll run an lftune --mix. And looks like our antenna is not quite lined up. There, that looks good. And then press enter. Next, we'll run LFT55 detect to detect the card. And it's detected it as FSK2A with RF of 50. We'll run LFT55 dump. And you can see our configuration block and our 3 user blocks. We'll run analyze LCR-D. Our header started with F337, and then our data was 29411042543C ECC2. And we'll go ahead and press enter, and it calculated that the XOR of those 8 bytes of data is the 76, which is exactly what we have following those 8 bytes of data. So if any of those 8 bytes of data get incorrectly read, the XOR shouldn't match. Next, we'll do an LF read, and then we'll do a data modulation. That's odd. Let me do another LF read here and a data modulation. Okay, this time it's showing us the correct modulation. That was interesting. Let's try it one more time. Yeah, okay, now it's working. I'm not sure what happened the first time. But we can see we're using a modulation of FSK. Our bit clock is RF50. And our 2 field clocks are FC divided by 10 and FC divided by 8. We'll learn more about those values in a minute. For now, we'll do a data raw demod --fs for FSK modulation. And again, our preamble is F337. So we're looking for 11100110011. And every 3 lines it repeats, but I'm not seeing that pattern anywhere in those 3 lines. And so next we'll do the data raw demod --fs-i for invert. And good news, on line 3, we're able to find that preamble. And then after the preamble, we have our 8 bytes of data and that checksum. Next, we'll run the data plot to visualize our buffer. And then I'll zoom in so we can see each of the samples. For 125 kHz RFID, each sample is 8 microseconds. Let's look at the 0 bit, which is FC divided by 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We have a clock every 8 samples, so we should have 6 1/4 waves and 50 samples. Now we'll look at the 1 bit, which is FC divided by 10. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We have a clock every 10 samples, so we have 5 waves in 50 samples. Each sample is 8 microseconds, so our field clock divide 10 would have a cycle every 80 microseconds, and our divide 8 would have a cycle every 64 microseconds. I recommend watching my previous video, which explains how to add a protocol file to your firmware. We won't be covering those steps in this video. In my video on adding InstaFob protocol, we learned how the flipper encodes Manchester signals using Manchester Advance. In this video, we'll look at the FSK signal-specific code, and I'll put a link to the protocol demo FSK files along with installation instructions. At the top of our file, we have a pound include for fskdemod.h. This demodulates a signal, and we use this for decoding signals. Next, we have a pound include for fskosc.h. This is the oscillator, and we use this for encoding signals. Our data is 8 bytes, 4 bytes for the latitude and 4 bytes for the longitude. And then we have that header, F337, and the XOR parity bit. So that makes 11 bytes for our encoded data. We define FSK demod for decoding our data, and then FSK osc for encoding our data. We also have encoded index for which bit we're encoding. And then pulse stores the duration of the low half of our pulse. We call FSK demod alloc, and we pass it 64 microseconds minus our jitter time, and we expect 6 pulses per bit. And then we pass it 80 microseconds plus our jitter time, and we expect 5 pulses per bit. Next, we call FSK osc alloc. We pass it our FC divided by 8, our FC divided by 10, and our RF50. We cast our data into a float pointer, which allows us to store our latitude in those first 4 bytes. And then we move 4 bytes and store a default longitude. Next, let's look at how we encode those 8 bytes of data. We start by setting card data to all zeros, and then we call write raw bit, passing it the bit, the index, and our card data array. And this just ends up calling bitlib set bits to turn on or off the bit. So we set the first 16 bits of card data to our preamble, F337. Then we use bitlib copy bits, and we copy 8 bytes from our decoded data buffer, starting at bit 0, into card data starting at bit 16. Then we set XOR to 0, and we loop over our 8 bytes of data, and we XOR the value with each byte of data. We use bitlib copy bits one more time. We'll copy 8 bits from XOR into the end of card data. And then finally, we use memcopy to just copy that card data into our encoded data. And you could use bitlib copy bits here if you preferred. So to write a tag, we'll call that encoder start. We'll set our configuration block as FSK2A, an RF of 50, and 3 user data blocks. Block 1 is our first 4 bytes of encoded data. Block 2 is the next 4 bytes. And block 3 is the last 3 bytes. And so we have to shift it over to the left 8 bits. Next, let's look at how a flipper 0 emulates a tag. We encode our data, set encoded index to 0 and pulse to 0. Then our encoder yield will get called. Our encoder pulse was 0. We'll get the bit at our encoded index. And then we'll call FSK osc next, passing it that bit. It will set our duration to 10 for a 1 bit and 8 for a 0 bit. And if it hasn't returned the same signal 5 or 6 times, it'll return false. And when it sent out enough signals for a full bit, it'll return true. When advance is true, we'll increase our encoded index to the next spot. And when we reach the end, we'll set it back to 0. This causes us to just keep looping the signal. Our duration is 8 or 10, but we actually need 4 high, 4 low, or 5 high, 5 low. We divide that duration in half, store the value in pulse, and set our level to true. The next time yield gets called, pulse will be set to non-zero. So we'll set our duration to pulse, set the pulse to zero, and set our level to false. And then finally, we return our level duration. Next, let's look at how a flipper zero decodes an FSK signal. We're passed a duration, such as 80 microseconds or 64 microseconds, and we're passed a level, which is true or false. We call FSK demod feed, passing it that level and duration. And typically, it will return a count of zero. But once it detects a frequency change, it will return the count of the previous bits and if they were true or false. In this example, we just finished reading 2 1 bits, so we would have a count of 2 and a value of true. Had they been 0 bits, we'd have a value of false. If the count is greater than 0, then we'll store each bit. We'll check to see if the protocol could be decoded. And if it can, we'll decode the protocol and return the result of true. To check if the protocol can be decoded, we see if the first 8 bits are F3, and then we check the next 8 bits for 3-7, and then we calculate the XOR of all of our data bits, and we compare the XOR with those last 8 bits. If any of those checks failed, we return false, otherwise we return true. To decode the data, we take our encoded data, starting at bit 16, and then we copy 8 bytes of data into decoded data, starting at bit 0. Now you know how the Flipper 0 can emulate FSK RFID signals, and you know how it can read FSK signals. We also learned a little more on how to use our ProxMark 3, and we made our own custom protocol that's able to do latitude and longitude. Please like and subscribe, and if you have any questions, leave them below or on my Discord server.